Morning students, how are you all? I hope all are good. Welcome back to my class. So children, tell me, when we go to cloth shop to buy cloth for making our school uniform, then the shopkeeper measures the cloth by comparing it with a standard unit of measuring. Yes or no? So without measuring, he didn't give correct measurement cloth. So we have to need to know exact measurements. So today our lesson is physical quantities and measurement. So in this video we learned about the density. First, what is meant by density? So density of an object can be defined as the mass of an object in a given volume. Different objects around has different densities. So density is defined as mass per unit volume. Density is a physical property of a matter. Density is a physical property of a matter. So density capital D is equal to mass by volume. Mass we have to consider here capital M, volume capital V. So what is the formula of density? Density is equal to mass by volume. Density is equal to mass by volume. So we define the density mass per unit volume. So from the above equation we can say that density is related to how closely atoms or molecules arranged in a material. So what is meant by atoms? In 6th class we already learned about the matter. In that matter lesson we learned about atom. What is meant by atom? So matter is made up of tiny particles called the atoms. So if the volume of an object is more for a given matter, then the density shall be less. Example, if we take two boxes, box A and box B. So box A is made from cardboard and box B made from metal. So they will weigh different. So the boxes are in the same size. Both boxes are same size, but the density of a metal is much higher than the cardboard. Density of a metal is much higher than the cardboard. Why? Means one is made from cardboard and another one made from metal. So they are in same size, but density is different. So the difference in weight is because of density of two materials. So the SI unit of density is kilogram per cubic meter, kg per meter cube. You should write like that only. See here. So density of metal is said to be 1 kilogram meter to the power of minus 3. Why they are given writing like this? Means here they are removing divided by. So that's why it will comes into upside. It becomes positive term to negative. So when a mass of 1 kg is packed in a volume of 1 meter cube. So in your textbook some examples are given. So I will explain one by one. See carefully. Open your textbook and see carefully. So first one is, a block of metal occupies a volume of 10 centimeter cube and weighs 32.5 kilograms. Now we have to calculate the density. So mass of a metal block, they are given in the question only 33.5 kg and the volume V 10 centimeter cube. Direct formula, this one we have to apply the values. Density is equal to mass by volume. Mass they are given this much and volume. So we get the answer when we divided these two, 3.35 kg centimeter cube. Next example, a container filled with 60 centimeter cube of a liquid weighs 90 grams. The container alone weighs 72 grams. Find the density of a liquid. So mass of a empty container, they are given 72 grams. And mass of a container plus liquid, they are given 90 grams. Now, what is the formula of density? Density of liquid is equal to mass of liquid by volume of liquid. So, mass of a liquid, we have volume of liquid, they are given 60 centimeter cube. So we have to calculate the mass of a liquid. So mass of a liquid is equal to 90 grams minus mass of a container. So 90 minus mass of a container, how much they are given? 72. 90 minus 72, 18 grams. and volume of a liquid they are given in question only 60 centimeter cube. So we have to substitute these one. So 18 grams per 60 centimeter cube, 0.3 gram per centimeter cube. So density of a liquid is equal to 0.3 gram per centimeter cube. Next, measuring density of solids. How to measure the density of solids? So we are easy to find density of regular solids. We have to find density of regular solids. We must measure the mass and volume of the solid and then divide the two. Divide the two means mass by volume to find the density. So in regular solids we are easily find the density. So mass of an object can be easily measured using a beam balance. How to measure? By using beam balance. And to calculate the volume of irregular shaped objects, we need to find their dimensions. We need to find their dimensions. So suppose we have irregular solids. How to measure the irregular solids of density? By using measuring density of a bit. It is very some difficult work. So we can measure the density of irregular solids like a stone, a block of wood, or a key by using measuring cylinders or Eureka cans. So we have to calculate the irregular solids density by using measuring cylinders or Eureka cans. First we discuss about the measuring cylinder. So let us discuss about measuring cylinder. So a measuring cylinder is an instrument used in laboratories. Measuring cylinder where we have to used we have to used in laboratories. So it is a cylindrical in shape and has markings on it. Measure the volume of liquid. So this is the measuring cylinder. So what is the shape? This is a cylindrical shape. And some markings of volumes of liquids also they are given here. See, so we can measure the volume of irregular solids using a measuring cylinder. So in this method, water is poured into the cylinder and the reading taken in the initial volume. So here see this, children. Here see this. So water is poured into the cylinder and the reading taken as the initial volume. Initial volume means V1. Now tie a thread with the irregular shaped solid objects. Immerse the objects completely in the cylinder containing water. This will result to change the level of the water. It will changes the level of a water. Next, note the readings of the final volume of a water in the cylinder. So that one is V2. Now we have to calculate the volume of irregular objects. Subtract the initial volume. Initial volume means V1 from the final volume means V2. So then we have to subtract initial volume from final volume and then calculate the density of the object using the formula density is equal to mass by volume. So like that only we have to calculate the density by using measuring cylinders in irregular solids. Next one is Eureka can. What is that? Next one is Eureka can. So a Eureka can is a container with a spout. Eureka can is a container with a spout with nearer to its top. Here see. Here with this spout nearer to its top. So Eureka can also called the displacement vessel. Eureka can is also called displacement vessels. So it is based on Archimedes principle. It is based on Archimedes principle. So according to Archimedes principles, which is the amount of water displaced by an object is equal to its volume. So the can is filled with water up to the maximum level and then object is placed in it. The solid object displaces some water which is collected in graduated measuring cylinder. The volume of object is equal to the volume of the water, then it is forced through the spout. So the density of an irregular solid can be calculated. The formula of density is equal to mass by volume. So we can find the volume of an object with a Eureka can and its mass with a balance. So we have to using the above formula, we can accurately calculate the density of given object. So once you see this one activity is there to measure the density of irregular solids using Eureka can. See this figure, everybody. So here, see, here some materials we want. First one is an irregular solid, such as a stone, and one Eureka can, and water, weighing balance, string, and a beaker. So next procedure. So as the stone was lowered to the Eureka can, first we have to suspend it, this thrown like this, and through it comes into the Eureka can. Some water got displaced, which was collected in separate beaker. This one separate beaker. The volume of a water displaced and collected in the beaker is the volume of solid objects. Suppose it be V. The density of a solid object is calculated by dividing the mass by the volume of the object. So density is equal mass by V volume. So by using formula, we have to measure the density of an irregular solids using Eureka can. Clear, children? How to measure the irregular solids by using Eureka can and measuring cylinder. Up to here, clear? Okay, children. Okay, children, that's all for today. Okay, in this video, I hope all are followed this video. Thank you. Have a nice day. We will meet into the another class.